So, what exactly is happening in the city?
Bloodshed, a massacre, which is why we gotta hurry. Not the friendliest pixies I've met.
They were put here to protect the Fading Sphere from intruders, meaning you.
Oh, unicorns! We must catch them. We won't have to walk everywhere then. I call the pink one.
It's over.
No, it's not. There's more. Another wolf behind you.
Ignore him. He always lies.
Aha. Boy who cried wolf. Still does, I suppose. And doesn't. When they actually appear.
The one and only. Listen, you little chit. Jack said you know what's become of his three beans.
I don't know anything. Not one thing. And besides, watch out. Wolves!
This'll be interesting. Right, let's get to it. Let's say for a minute you know what happened to the red bean. Where wouldn't it be?
For certain, no one swallowed it. Oh no, definitely not that.
Of course not. But say someone didn't. Who would it be that didn't swallow it?
A human. The most human human in the land of a thousand fables. Everyone! Wolves!
Bet you haven't heard what happened to the blue bean. Maybe? Not at all? Right?
I've heard it lies about somewhere, out in the open.
Just like that? No one guarding it?
Nobody! Three times over! Help! Wolves!
Yellow bean. Don't know a thing about it, right?
It's somewhere very, and I mean very deep. So deep, in fact, it's completely underground.
And who has it,
A bold farmhand, who in no way and not at all awaits someone. Not in the slightest. Good folk! Wolf!
Say that word one more time and I'll chop you up. Feed you to the fishes. Understood?
All right, we should go.
Watch out for wolves!
Tough to talk to, that one.
Was it, though? You need merely remember he always lies. Or more precisely, refers us the truth.
Where to now?
I'm not sure. We should visit some of the other fables. The meaty ones, that is. Perhaps then Joss's hints will make more sense. It's just a few. Red Riding Hood, Piglets and Bears, three of each. And Goldilocks, of course. Then Longlocks, and a little lass who sells flint.
Ah, fine. Let's get to work. Incredible. You must have loved this place.
I did at first. But children get bored quickly. Even tea parties with a whole cackle of princesses eventually turn dull and routine.
What did you do then?
Dropped the black lady in the swan's nest once. Yes.
Ah!
care for a cigarillo? A bit of tobacco? A dab of fistech?
Remind me, what tale are you from?
Sold flints when I was a lass. But no one bought them, so I branched out. Now I deal in snuffs, puffs, all sorts of fun things. What'll you have, sweeties?
Magic beans. Do you have any?
If it's not the new name of some kicker I already have, dearies, then no. But maybe you'd like some.
Hey, where'd you get that ribbon? That's mine.
Is that so? Then why was it lying in the bushes? Finders keepers, sweetheart.
The ribbon. Mind explaining what the fuss is about?
There's not much to explain. I got it from Aturius Vigo when I was a child. It was to protect me from evil. It clearly didn't work, given how I ended up.
But it means a lot to you.
How should I put this? I have so few mementos from my childhood, and the ribbon reminds me of the good old days, when I was someone else.
Dears, could you continue this touching scene elsewhere, You're scaring away my customers.
Give Sienna the ribbon. Why not, huh?
Sugar Plum. The only thing I hand out for free is a first hit. To get them to come back for a second, of course. For all else, you've got to pay.
What if I asked you nicely?
Ask me nicely and I might play you for it. A round of cards?
All right, let's play. If you lose, you give me the ribbon.
Don't get your hopes up. None can best me at Gwent. Rumpel, you're good at this. A word once given. The ribbon's yours. Now skedaddle.
Tell me.
What?
What you want in return. You're not doing this out of the kindness of your heart.
Don't want anything in return.
I... Thank you.
My new attire reveals itself but to the wise and cultured.
Watch out, pixies!
Show me what you got.
Three little pig's arms. You know the story, don't you? Who's afraid of the big bad wolf?
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Brick's the only one left.
We should look inside. Remember Joss's words?
One being lies out in the open, guarded by three nobodies. Yeah, could be it. the big bad Witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a beam.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Stunted a bit, but yeah, it's there.
Well, well, aren't you full of surprises? What else are you hiding behind that gruff exterior?
Not a bad singer. Do a pretty mean rendition of The Maids of Vicovaro, for instance. But some other time, maybe.
But here we are chatting away when there's work to do. We must keep looking. So, do you like it here?
No. Got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it. Doesn't seem to be at home.
I adored her. My darling little sis. So adorable. So sweet. Yet when they banished me from the palace, she didn't so much as peek out of the window.
She might not have known. Maybe just couldn't.
And could she also not grant me amnesty when she was crowned? Please.
Hello? Can we talk?
Shmoombotch, my head! Damn it all! I swear that was the last time I drank with Redbeard! Oh, Sianna, a bloody long time it's been. You've changed.
Whereas you, not at all, big bad wolf. Though it seems you've started running with the wrong crowd.
And who should I run with, eh? Thumbelina? One shot and she's under the table. But, what brings you?
You could always have a drink with us.
Oh, what now? Not on your life. I can barely stand, I'm so hungover.
You know what they say about the hair of the dog?
Out of the question! And why must you drink? Do you wish to drown some sorrow? And I don't mean to pry, but you don't look much like a young duchess to me.
They stripped me of my title and birthright, then banished me. A family spat, let's say.
Listen, looking for magic beans. Seen any?
I was given one for safekeeping, but...
Where is it? Talk!
Shh, not so loud.
Oh, I can be much louder than this. And resort to other means of persuasion.
Right there, the threats! Sianna to a T. Listen, I exist to restage a fairy tale. If you want to play at it, I'll be happy to oblige. But it won't be easy. The thing is, Little Red Riding Hood's popped her clogs.
What?
1,000 times they cut my gut open, filled it full of rocks and drowned me in the river. So once you stopped coming, I decided to repay the little imp for all her loving labor. Who'd know what's at the bottom of the well, she and the hunter? Which means we can't play, and I'm under no obligation to talk to you. Not about beans, nor anything else. So leave me be. Sod off.
Wolf's pretty cranky.
Surprised? Think about it. He was cast in the role of the Nemesis without ever asking for it. It's a dog's life, I tell you.
So, what now?
Don't worry. I'll play with him. Or rather, play him. I just need that little red hood. The piece of apparel, that is. Not the poor girl's corpse.
That's a relief.
You wish to help me? Here's your chance. Jump in the well and fish it out. Well, chop chop.
Well,
break a leg. luck?
Yep. Look what I got.
That would never fit you. Give it to me. How do I look?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let's go see the big bad wolf.
Let me guess. You'll play the granddaughter.
Mm-hmm. And you, the hunter.
You again? I thought that was clear. I will not talk to you if little Red Riding Hood is not with you!
Not a problem. Sianna can take her place.
What? Very well. It's not as if I can forbid you. Granddaughter, come closer, sweetie.
But Grandmama, what big eyes you have.
Better to see you with, my dear.
Granny, what big arms you have.
Better to embrace you with, my dear.
And Grandmama, what big teeth you have. Eh?
The better to eat you with, my dear!
Remember what Joss said about the red beam? A human has it, and he definitely didn't swallow it.
Mm-hmm. Gotta open his belly. Bottle caps, fake teeth, a corkscrew. Ah, here it is. Red beam.
Well then, one step closer to our goal.
What?
Now I find myself wondering if you're just horribly discreet, or if those mutations completely scrubbed away your curiosity. Are you really not interested in what happened? In what became of me after they cast me out?
Well, since you brought it up, I'd gladly hear the rest. Let's see. They had escorted you out of the duchy.
Yes. And the noble knights of Toussaint and I didn't stop until we reached the Ketdu wilderness. They left me there alone, without a copper, in a torn lace dress, right when the frosts were setting in. They assumed something would eat me, or that I'd do everyone a favor and die of hunger. But as always, I failed to live up to expectations. I wandered the woods for a week, went purple from the cold, gnawed the bark on twigs. Finally, I saw a light among the trees. A campsite. They were bandits. Bearded. Drunk. Spattered with blood. I was sure they'd rape me or kill me. Or both.
Take it neither happened?
That's when I learned a robber and a murderer can be a better man than a knight in shining armor. They took me in. We set off for Nizer. And I did what I could to repay them. I advanced in their ranks rather quickly, and eventually I became their leader of the whole ragged band.
Should have stayed there, maybe.
Perhaps. Perhaps I should have forgotten everything, started a new life. But you know what? There came a point when I thought, you wanted a monster, then a monster you shall get.
Been through a lot.
I have. And throughout this time, my sister was stomping grapes and shagging minstrels on down bedding.
She wasn't the one to banish you.
And I'm not angry at her for that. I'm angry at her because she forgot about me.
Right. We've had our chat. Come. Know what? They need names. I'll call mine... Anise.
Call mine Roach.
Roach? Are you serious? Ugh.
Three bears.
Three stools, three bears, three bears.
One a bit too big, the other too small. Too mutilated. Hard to say anything.
She got what she deserved, as I see it. Always took what she wanted without asking.
No being here. Gotta keep looking. Take it easy. This Longlock's tower?
Indeed. It's even taller than I remember.
Wait. What Joss said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a walled farmhouse deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go.
Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing's not my strong suit.
Prince's corpse. Tried to free Longlocks, but fell and broke his neck. For nothing.
So?
Got the bean, but Longlocks. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That why you cozied up to a vampire?
Detlaf was a tool, and only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
To use him. Was that your plan from the start?
No. At first, I was simply intrigued. Do you know the story? It was in Matina, a few years past. I'd gone there to pass some loot off to a fence I know. We were hashing out the terms when in walked Detlaf. He said he'd come to sell a silver candlestick and gripped it through a cloth. That caught my eye. I followed him out, observed him from a distance, but he caught on quickly.
Yeah, superhuman senses will do that.
He turned down a blind alley. I followed. He jumped out from behind a crate, baring his teeth. I suppose he'd wanted to frighten me. Alas, he didn't in the least. After all, I'm a monster too, am I not?
A higher vampire and you were unimpressed? Don't know if that's brave or just plain foolish.
I've always had a way with ostensibly dangerous, quiet types.
That's supposed to be about me, too?
Ugh, bother. I hate to disappoint you, Geralt, but your belly button is not the center of the known world. No, you do remind me of him a bit. Stifling all emotions inside you. Ever feigning indifference. You see, when I met Detlaf, I... Somehow I knew, call it intuition, that he meant me no harm. That he was trying to frighten me off, for he, too, was scared. Now, do you understand?
I guess. What happened then?
We talked, then met up once, twice, three times. Enough that he became infatuated. I truly enjoyed it at first. But only at first. He did not love like a man, but like an animal, madly, deeply, unconditionally. Wildly. To return such a feeling, anyone would be hard-pressed. Let alone someone as twisted as I am.
So there came a day you just up and disappeared?
Yes. There was no other way. Let's just be friends, or... I don't deserve you. He'd never have understood that sort of thing. But then, once I decided to return, clean up some old affairs, I remembered him, and concluded he could still be of use.
Playing with fire, that.
Definitely. And either I'll get burned, or I'll burn all else down. No other options.
Got a history with Detlaf now. So this meeting will be different. Not afraid?
I can handle him.
Mm-hmm. Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go. Just a bit more work and we'll be able to say sot off to this fecking fable sphere. Now we must plant them by the path near Longlock's tower, then prepare to meet the giant. Beans. Wait.
Why?
The stalk will sprout abruptly, very abruptly. We must be careful. All right, toss them.
it's always gonna go wrong.
The home stretch. Admire the view later. First, we must deal with... him.
Tail creature, that was one tough son of a wench.
I told you this land had gone ape mad, though I did not expect it to be so severe.
Can't help thinking you might have done that on purpose.
Why ever would I have?
To get rid of your guard, your captor. Getting close to the exit at this point. Probably think you don't need me anymore.
Well, you're wrong. You still stand to be quite useful to me.
So? How? Plan to use me like you did Detloff?
No, I need you for a purpose far simpler. Now don't just stand there and stare. I need a man, Geralt, and I'm not afraid to say it. I've no idea what awaits me once we leave this place. Treat it as my last wish.
Another time, another place, maybe. No offense.
None taken. You spoke clearly, you spoke honestly. It's fine. Come. The exit's this way. Not to be trusted.
Just curious. Why do you want the Heart of Toussaint and the Ducal Wine?
They were my right, my due.
Doubt we would have figured you out if you hadn't tried to get them. Know that, don't you?
I do. And I regret nothing. One lives but once. Here.
bottles in a fountain? Not terribly practical.
It was a secret passage. Anarieta and I would use it to...
hide from your governess. Which luckily she noted down in her diary, thus I knew where to await you. Never mind that. Has the young lady agreed to help clean up the mess she's made?
She has. And stop treating me as if I were a child.
Would you prefer I treated you like the lying manipulator you are?
Regis, what happened to your famous manners?
Apologies. I forgot myself.
Let's go. Really want to be done with this. Nice place,
isn't it? Offers a lovely view of the valley. On a clear day, you can see the outlines of Duntine.
Is it, though? A ruin like any other, I think.
So sensitive. So aware. Honestly, what did Detlef ever see in you?
Perhaps he'll tell you himself.
You nervous?
Mm-hmm. It's always a bit nerve-wracking meeting an ex. And especially so when said ex is a vampire.
I doubt he'll be in the mood for jests.
I know. Ugh. May I be honest? Yes. I'm nervous. I really would prefer just to run off. I gave my word I would help, I know. But how much is that worth? Yet I owe him this meeting. And that is that.
Let's get ready. Detlef will be here any moment now.
Sianna, Sianna, I have a question I must ask you. Did you truly feign it all? That which bound us was a ruse?
Detlef, it's not that simple.
Oh no, it's very simple. You either deceived me or not. In forgiving you, I grieve. For now, we must part.
What? But how?
The ribbon?
Ha! Seems I've been fooled again. She will pay for this sooner or later! She will pay! I should have meddled, Witcher!
disappear!
I didn't plan any of it.
Silence! Yeah.
Leave him to me. Be gone.
I can't let...
I insist.
Thank you.
My, what a smashing ensemble. You wear it well.
Shut up. I look like a twit.
The caftan is sewn of the best fabrics available, and according to the best tailoring practices. But one must have a modicum of taste to appreciate this. Even the most exquisite robes cover only deficiencies in beauty, never in refinement.
Rather not bicker about taste. Don't like to. It's neither interesting nor productive.
This particular witcher has an inborn intolerance for formal occasions. Yet he's to attend just such an event shortly. I expect that's the source of his prickliness. So try not to take things personally, Master Taylor. Rather pity him, for in truth, stage fright overwhelms him. He trembles at the thought that he has no notion how to behave in the presence of Her Grace's Majesty.
As well he should. All that being as it may, Toussaint's highest honor, the Order of Vitis Vinifera, demands appropriate attire. The Duchess cannot be expected to drape the medal on a suit of armor caked in mud. Palace protocol places enormous emphasis on form, virtuous tradition, etiquette.
Huh. A tradition which values appearances ahead of all else, which calls for lordly, glistening triviality, and misplaced generosity.
Sound wistful. Pensive, Regis. That because they refuse to buy you a new outfit?
Hardly. It's the tone I ever adopt when I find myself pondering, which, believe it or not, happens quite a lot. Besides, I've no need for a new outfit, as I shall not be attending the ceremony.
Why not?
Because, unlike you, I don't have to. I shall begin to pack my belongings instead. I trust you'll join me later, once you're richer by a medal and a fascinating new experience.
Count on it. Ceremonies, medals honoring virtues, just keeps coming up.
I've had no reprieve either, and I keep thinking of the last great virtue, compassion. It's the one piece of the puzzle that never seemed to fit.
Mean you suddenly believe the five virtues theory, after all we've revealed?
It's not a question of belief, superstition, or old wives' tales. It's a conclusion derived through exercising pure logic. Siana planned everything in advance. Had we not stopped her, surely there'd have been a fifth victim. One the gossips would have associated with a lack of compassion.
Her plans don't matter now. Can't act on them. Ask the messenger who delivered my invitation to the ceremony. Siana's in the palace. Courtiers pressured the Duchess to lock her in a tower.
Do you care not a whit who else was in her black book? We've some time before the ceremony. We could still chat with that boot-cleaning urchin. He was the one to pass the victim's names to Detlaff. Perhaps we missed something.
Regis, Bootblack didn't say anything about making deliveries when we talked to him. How do you know he handled the letters?
While you basked in glory and tried on new formal wear, I conducted a little investigation of my own. You'd be very proud to see how I conducted myself. I began by concocting an ample supply of boot wash for our enterprising young friend. I'd observed that among street folk, amidst their society as a whole, reciprocity takes precedence over all other codes, and thus no good deed goes unrewarded. Of course, the same holds true for malicious or destructive deeds.
The letters, what's the connection?
When the bootblack arrived to collect his bucketful, he hinted he knew more. Simply put, we'd failed to ask the proper questions when we chatted earlier. It took a bit more tongue-loosening, but ultimately he spoke. He admitted he'd handed Detlaff the letters. He knew this information was valuable to me. In providing it, he was simply repaying me.
All in all, why not check up on that? We'll go together, assuming we're done here.
I am done, yes. It lies in your hands now to see if you are able to present my handiwork at the ceremony with the dignity it is due. Or if you will first destroy it, crawling about the city's underbelly.
Promise to be careful.
It's the swordsman! Good to see you. Here for a spiffing? Dirty boots are a stain on professional dignity, you know. Step on up!
Need to ask you something.
Yet again? Go on, then. I'm a proponent of free speech, and I will gladly tell you all I know. But why not get your boots shanked while we jabber?
Guess they could use a spit and polish.
Then I shall take advantage as well. A friend of mine used to say boots should be as clean as the soles that wear them.
Clean boots, clean soles. A fine slogan.
How's business?
Well enough. I can't complain. Though it'd be even better were certain folk to sit down for a shine as they stood and chatted.
Man in the frock coat. You passed him some letters, remember?
Why, of course. I'm young, got a mind like a steel trap, but...
If you're about to tell me this information will cost me, forget it. How'd you get those letters?
Beckers brought them.
Why didn't you tell us this before, when we first talked?
You didn't ask about beggars now, did you?
Beggars. Tell us more about them. How many were there?
Why, four. One for each letter.
Just four? Sure you didn't get a fifth?
I can count, you know.
Remember anything else? These beggars have anything in common?
What? Come now. Each was different. Some had mismatched boots, others had no boots at all. Oh, I know! They all had no home!
Kid, my patience is starting to run a little thin. Now think hard. Where'd they get the letters? They pick them up, get them from someone?
I don't know. They'd come, hand me a letter, and walk away. I asked no questions.
Geralt, allow me to ask a question. Listen, lad. I'll be glad to mix another batch of that bootshine for you. But you must focus now and tell us all you know. Where can we find the beggars?
Well, at the shelter, most like.
Where's that?
Everyone knows. It's just round the corner. Up those stairs, then right.
Thanks, kid. For your trouble. We must visit the shelter. Look around inside.
Blast. I hawked up a bit of sick. You've to move your little camp elsewhere, got it? You? What do you want?
To talk.
Here, that's a waste of breath. We've tried it, only to tire our lips. We'll use other means of persuasion now.
Gentlemen, calm, please.
Either get out along with these flea-ridden vagabonds, or we'll toss you all out. Our patience is gone. This place is no longer a rank refuse dump.
Scram! Decent folk live here.
The shelter. Them living here bothers you. Question is why.
Look, Ballard. Another defender of the poor. Fighter for justice.
Damn nuisance. We've our women and young folk living next door. When even grown men fear to walk past such rabble.
Decent folk you mention. Mean yourselves.
Why? Do you doubt it?
Hell yes.
Hear that, Artois? He poking insults us. On our own turf.
We should step aside, good fellow. My friend is perfectly capable of settling this unfortunate dispute on his own.
Grey hair, puppy number. All right. I can take a hint. Come, time to go.
I thank you so much for your aid. I tried to reason with them, but they'd have beat me blue had you not come along. I'm grateful. Immensely.
What did they want from you?
They are neighbors. Wish me to take my folk, the shelter, elsewhere. They dislike that I help the Beckers. I do not oppose going elsewhere, were we to have somewhere to go. But you've come with a problem, have you? My turn to aid you.
What is this place? Poorhouse?
You could call it that. They come here to rest and eat a hot meal.
You help them, why?
Because they need help.
Need some information. Looking for a man who might have mentioned the bootblack in Rue de Garl.
The bootblack? A feisty lad. I know him.
Any of your, wards supposed to meet him recently or soon?
Forgive me. Those I help and I are not so close that I would know. But should you wait, they'll all soon come for their meal. You can question them yourselves.
Sure all your usual beggars will be here?
They're not obliged to come, of course. But they rarely find a decent meal elsewhere. So, almost all in the area eat here.
Thanks. We'll wait. Nice of you to let us.
My dears, I've a matter to address before I serve the soup. These two gentlemen have some questions of you. Pay attention. Answer in brief. For if you draw it out, your soup will go cold, and we wouldn't want that, would we?
Recently, four of you delivered sealed letters to the bootblack. I know this.
Does anyone know what the gentleman means? Go on, speak up. Romain?
Why should I squeal? You were all told not to mention the letters. We all swore.
You can tell me, Romain. You were given a letter and you delivered it, right? Good work, Romain. Thank you. Who else?
I got the one too. Gave it to the bootblack. Freshie? He got one. But he can't tell you. As he's not here.
I still have mine. I'm to deliver it 2 days after the Feast of St. Barnabas.
It's a matter of importance to the Duchy. Hand it over, or I'll take it from you, plain and simple.
But I was to deliver it personally. Let no one else see it. That is what she said, and she was frightened.
You ought to heed folk who are kind and honest. These men helped me a short while ago, helped all of us. If this individual threatened you, you need not keep the promise you made.
All right, take it. I didn't want to see the bootblack anyways. It's always muddy there.
Damn it.
What is it? Another name, truly?
See for yourself.
Well, well. I must say, even I did not expect this. This time you will see to our Duchessa. It seems we underestimated Siana rather grossly.
Judging by this, Detloff was literally supposed to tear her heart out.
Yet first you must snap her neck. Puzzling.
Puzzle complete now.
Alas, the matter's ceased to be a tantalizing brain tease and has turned incredibly grave. We've proof of a plot to assassinate Toussaint's ruler. We've proof of a coup d'etat.
Duchess was to be Detloff's last victim. Siana planned it from the start.
Indeed. The logical conclusion, Geralt.
Four seemingly random victims to start. The virtue's their only link. Enough to get folk talking about a righteous, vengeful beast. obscured the victim's links to Sianna, even as she had those she despised killed off one by one, leaving the Duchess for last.
Had she managed to fulfill her plan, none would have questioned the reasons. Most would have thought Anna Henrietta had died for her sins. She was known to show a hard heart on many occasions, ample proof of a lack of compassion.
Why would Sianna murder her own sister? Out of envy? To take power? From an inborn penchant for evil?
Yes, yes, and yes. All seem likely, and none are mutually exclusive. But if you'd like to know for certain, you could always ask her yourself.
Actually, love to learn her motives.
Praiseworthy, I suppose. Sometimes one should stare evil in the face.
Seems a bit strong, no?
She used my friend as her tool for killing. I believe I've every right to condemn her, but I support your lust for the truth. Some philosophers think empirical examination the sole path to knowledge. I believe you mentioned the Duchess keeps Sianna locked up.
Courtiers were insisting on a harsher punishment. Much harsher. Think Anna Henrietta had to protect her sister from a lynch mob as much as she wanted to protect her subjects from a criminal. One way or another, she's locked away in a secluded wing of the palace, awaiting trial before a court of law. I'd need to get past some guards to see her. Coming with?
Of course not. I shall await you at Mare La Chaise Longue. I'll not risk entering the palace after Detlaff and his minions rampage.
Besides, I vastly prefer the company of a simple mug of mandrake brew to that of the Duchess's vile sister.
So, said straight up, it means you're going off to get drunk because you hate Sianna.
I've never been fond of categorical statements of that kind, but I admit I could not vouch for my behavior in her presence.
She treated Detlaff cruelly.
Caused his death in the end, and now this? Atop all that? No, Geralt. I will not go with you. I will await you at the cemetery.